नमस्ते, वेलकम. दिस इज़ अरुणा पत्की, डॉक्टर ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक मेडिसिन, योग टीचर, नेशनली रिकग्नाइज्ड LMBT, NCBTMB प्रोवाइडर, NCBTMB प्रोवाइडर एज वेल एज BCTMB. आई एम हियर टुडे टू शेयर द विजडम ऑफ आयुर्वेदा विथ ऑल ऑफ यू. लेट्स लर्न अबाउट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फूड. फूड इज़ अ मेडिसिन इन आयुर्वेदा. Whatever you eat is important. At the same time, how you are cooking is important, because the health is directly proportional to your food, and the food is directly proportional to your combinations of the food, and the combinations of food are directly proportional to the way of cooking and the way of adding and mixing the material into the cooking aspect. So let's learn today's recipe, which is called it as a tapioca. What I did yesterday night, this is a tapioca, okay? So I took the tapioca and washed the tapioca for 2 times, okay? And then I kept just this much water on top of the tapioca. So I have 2 bowls of tapioca. This bowl, I took 2 bowls of tapioca. And I soaked it, washed it 2 times and soaked it water above it, just 2 inches of water above it, okay? So just if tapioca is here, you just put the water a little bit above and let it sit for the rest of the night. In the morning, this is like this. It's, you know, you can press it, you know, this is how it looks like, okay? So now this is ready for use. Now, this is a cast iron pan, I'm using it. And here we are going to add our ghee. So ghee is the most important ingredient in the Ayurvedic cooking. Why? I will tell you very soon. Okay, so I have 1 spoon full of ghee here in the pan. Okay, now the important ingredients what we need in the wet, as a wet ingredients, is I have 2 small bowls of 2 small potatoes, washed, clean and chopped, 3 green chilies, 1 tablespoon of cumin, and a fistful, 1 bowl of cilantro and 1 lime, okay? So first thing which goes in the warm ghee is our cumin seeds. Cumin is a carminative. It's very good for digestion, that's why we are using. Second ingredient which goes is our green chili. And the third ingredient which goes is our potatoes. Chopped, cleaned, washed potatoes. 2 small baby potatoes, medium size. Okay, now let us stick this here and get some of the other ingredients what we need for this. Okay, so we will take ingredients. So you can skip this because this is a paprika powder. Okay, this is a red chili powder. So I'm going to add for color. But as it is a green chili inside, you don't have to. That is totally optional. I have cumin powder. What I did, I roasted the cumin and I made the powder out of it, and now this is ready to use in my food. And this is a sea salt and this is a pink salt. So salt to taste, as simple as that is. So until the potatoes get cooked and soft for 1 minute, we will talk about the effects of the tapioca on the body. So tapioca is a gooey food, okay? It's like, if you see this, this is a kind of a sticky, gooey food, right? So tapioca is a food which is very aggravating to the kapha dosha in the body, the earth element in the body. It increases the wet in the body, or it enhances the mucus in the body, okay? So this is very good for people who are a pitta as well as a vata, pitta as well as vata body type, okay? Now, understand the effects of the tapioca. Okay, tapioca is very good to use as a food form, as well as a snack form, as well as a porridge form. But today we are doing some combinations, like a spicy combination of it. Okay, tapioca, as it absorbs the water, right, it's the same thing. It is going to absorb the water in the body, as it is an earthy element. Okay, so it creates the dryness in the body, or it can create the constipation. So people who are suffering with constipation, gases, bloating, they should not eat this food. Okay, now the tapioca is like it's a raisin of the tree. It is like a extraction from the tree, you know, like a gugul, you know, in Ayurveda we have a gugul, which is also extraction. So this is extraction of the tree, like a raisin, you know. Now let me see. Yep, see, this is nice and brown. Okay, and it's cooked very well. Let me check and make sure that this is cooked properly. Yep, it is cooked. Okay, so I can pass the fork part easily, so it is cooked properly. Now I'm going to add this ingredient here. Okay, like this. Now I will be adding salt to taste. Salt, and so I have two small spoons, so which is a half teaspoon. So salt to taste. So I'm adding 1 teaspoon of the black salt, pink salt, and 1 teaspoon of the sea salt. Okay, so salt is done. Now I will just add a little bit of paprika, chili powder. This is just optional. I will ask you to skip it if you are not fond of the spices. I am going to cook spicy. Okay, and now this is the most important ingredient which we will be adding. So let's mix it very well here, like this. As this is an earthy food, it has an earth element heavily in it, earth and water. Okay, earth and water, but I will say more earthy side. Earth element is profuse in this food. Okay, so people who have sufferings with the, they can't sleep, they are unable to sleep, they are not able to have a nice good night's sleep, then this is an awesome food. Okay, now I'm going to add this 1 bowl. Okay, this is a peanut powder. So what I did, I took peanuts like this. This is called it as a peanut. Okay, this is a peanut. So I took the peanut and I did roast it, sauteed it just plain on the heat, medium heat, until the skin cover turns to be brown and you can smell the aroma, the oil from the peanut. Okay, now once it cools off, then you blend it in the mixer and make a powder out of it. I'm going to give it a nice stir here. So the substitute to the peanut powder here, you can use almond flour or pine nuts flour. So if you are allergic to any to the nuts, then you have to skip the nut part out of it, and it will not taste that yummy. But you can definitely replace it with some I will suggest like a almond flour or cashew flour or peanut flour or sesame seed powder. Okay, any powder is fine if you are allergic to one of this. So let's cover the lid for second, and we'll saute it in between, and we will talk about the tapioca. So tapioca, we eat a tapioca in an Ayurvedic way, because in Ayurveda we have always considered food to nourish the body and energize the body. So here, when I'm using tapioca, I am using some antidotes into it, so it will not bother us to create a lot of dryness in the body. So that is the main reason of eating the food, not with a consciousness, eating the food with the awareness, so that we can manage the health of our digestive system. This is the proper way of eating Ayurvedically, because this is a carbohydrate. It's a white color carbohydrate, and which is a grain, which is an extract, which is a raisin from the plant. Okay, so this is very, very nutritive. It brings the vitality and strength and energy. It is a nice food to use for pitta as well as vata type of people. Kapha type of people, they can reduce it, or they can add 1 teaspoon of black pepper and 1 teaspoon of ginger powder here. Ginger powder, I'm saying ginger powder here, so that it will help us to calm down the excessive accumulation of kapha, and it will soothe our respiratory tract. Okay, this is a very good nourisher for the plasma tissue in the body. Okay, in Ayurveda, we talk about all the 7 tissues in the body. 7 tissues, they are the building blocks of the body. Okay, so I'm making sure it's not getting sticky at the bottom, otherwise it will start burning. Okay, so this food is a little heavier side. That's why we have a lot of cumin and cumin powder and cumin seeds. And now, as it is cooked properly, see? Yes, it is cooked. Let me check whether it's cooked now. I'm going to just taste it. See, always when I cook the food, this is what I get. Yes, it's a proper sign of proper cooking. Because your aromatic oils, aromas of the food, everything is getting inhaled in my nose, in my respiratory system. So this is a very, very proper sign of proper cooking, you know. This is the best way of making the proper combinations of the food. And I feel a little spice here, so I should have avoided the red chili powder. Mm-hmm, yummy, yummy. Now, the most important thing, what we need to do here is we need to add the lime juice. So I will be adding the lime juice. I love the lime. Why we are using the lime here? As I told you, right? So the most important thing, what happens here is like, you need to make the proper combinations, and these are the proper combinations of the food that we are using, because lime is a good digestive food. It enhances the taste, but at the same time it helps for the digestive secretions in the body. You know, by looking at the lime itself, your saliva starts drooling. Don't you think that it has a direct connection with your brain, direct connection with your psychology in the body, your emotional system in the body, you know? So it's amazing to consider, look at the food, smell the food, proper combination of the food. And let me see if they are all getting mixed very well. Mm-hmm. Wow. This is all ready. My job is here to mix it. So you can remove the green chilies before you use the cilantro, because green chili and cilantro both looks green. Sometimes you might eat the green chili, so make sure if you are giving this to the kids, you remove the green chilies by looking at them. Okay, otherwise it's going to be very, 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 very spicy. And this is our healthy way of eating tapioca. So what I'm going to do, this is how you serve this is a fresh coriander from my garden, like this, and you put some more lime onto it and eat your food. This is the healthier version of tapioca. This is a sattvic food. It can, if you cook it properly and this proper way, then it will not increase your acidic level in the body. It will not be acidic, but this is